morning, everyone. Our idea is taking a bite out of hunger and lending a hand to disabilities. My name is Taylor Lundy, and my partner is Jacqueline Manny, and we are both from the University of Illinois, which is located about 2 hours south of Chicago. We became involved with BCFN YES when we studied abroad last spring in Rome. We decided to focus on disabilities and food insecurity because we both have experience with disabled family members. My personal experience involves my older sister, who suffers from a muscular disorder. Currently, she has a very strong support system that is able to take care of her. However, the future is unexpected, and someday she could be out without this support. Today, I'm going to share with you an idea we have to solve this issue. So what exactly is food insecurity? The USDA has defined food insecurity as consistent access to adequate food is limited by lack of money or other resources at times during the year. The FAO found that from 2011 to 2013, 842 million people suffered from food insecurity across the world. Of this amount, 49 million people resided in the United States. Disability has emerged as a strong leading factor that affects households' food security. This is due to expensive medicine as well as medical equipment that is essential for survival. This leads less availability for a healthy diet. In the US, food insecurity exists nearly everywhere. We have decided to focus on two large cities in the Midwestern region of the country. These cities are St. Louis, Missouri, and Chicago, Illinois. We have chosen these two cities because this is where my partner and I are from. We're the most familiar with these communities, and we strongly believe that the hospitals in these areas will be a key component to implementing our idea. Now, what is our idea? Our idea consists of an online platform involving four key roles. The first role is people in the community who suffer from a disability. The next role is caregivers. Caregivers are people who offer aid to someone who suffers from a disability or disease in the comfort of their own home. This would be someone such as a family member, a friend, a neighbor, etc. The next role involves dietitians. And the final role involves volunteers of the community who offer their time to assist others. So in the end, we have people with disabilities, caregivers, dietitians, and volunteers of the community all coming together to create our online resource, Take a Bite, Give a Bite. This website will be accessible via computers and mobile devices. Here's a breakdown of how each role will utilize their platform. Individuals with disabilities will create a profile. If they're unable to create this profile themselves, their caregivers will have the ability to create this for them. On this profile, they will describe and explain the needs that they need assistance with. Lastly, they will connect with a volunteer in the community and receive this aid. The next role is community volunteers. These people will also create a profile where they will share their available assistance. They will connect with a member in the community who is suffering from a disability, and then they will deliver this aid to this person. Next, we have dietitians. They will provide healthy recipes and healthy tips to live a healthier lifestyle and also answer any questions the community may have. Lastly, we have caregivers. Caregivers will also be able to create a profile where they will save recipes and tips that they find beneficial, and if they find they need extra assistance, they can also connect with a volunteer in the community. Our projected timeline for our idea includes 1 month to find two professional dietitians. In 2 to 4 months, we will create our website. In five to six months, we will launch our website. And after launching our website for 6+ months, we will continue to advertise to gain awareness in the public of our idea. As far as advertising, we have deemed our early adopters as caregivers and volunteers, as well as people with disabilities. We plan to target these people by advertising in hospital and clinics, billboards, radio, and through the internet via computers and mobile devices. Here you will find the projected cost of our idea. you can see that with 10,000 euro, we have the ability to change the quality of many lives. After 1 year of implementation of our idea, we plan to expand and improve our platform. We plan to expand two different ways, externally and internally. Externally, we plan to expand and target other parts of the US and eventually the world. Internally, we plan to expand by improving and updating our website, as well as gaining a strong loyalty among our caregivers, volunteers, and dietitians. By a strong loyalty, this will only increase our project to more people. Lastly, we would like to create a mobile app. Creating a mobile app will increase the efficiency and benefits of our users. With a large percentage of the population suffering from food insecurity due to a disability, an online resource such as our website can strongly change the lives of many. As I mentioned earlier, my sister suffers from a muscular disorder. If someday she were to be without the care she has today, I strongly believe that a website such as Take a Bite, Give a Bite could change her life for the better. As you can see, this platform is a never-ending cycle and would not be able to be possible without each active role. Thank you.